Hello everyone, today I'll be showing you people how to run ANSYS APDL macro code in MATLAB. So by starting with the macro code, here the first line which says parameter dot parameter and file type INP. This is the file which has a variable parameters which you would like to change of each run. So just use a simple MATLAB code to and use fprint f to write any variable value into this file and run this macro file. So and these are the set variable which I am not changing, basically mesh sizes. And this is a simple macro code, and only change comes after solution. So after solve is done, I am just transferring all the output of ANSYS to the file post.txt, and what input does is it brings in the export.mac file, and export.mac file has a get function which takes the result, this is the results, and puts it into the variable, some variable name like 011, 022 as well as 033. Then these variables are written using vwrite into a file you specify using output, and f is just a floating point which specifies the format of the values you want to be written into the text file. Use fscanf to read the text file and just export the value of the text file into your Excel sheet or something. And this is again storing the output into the post file. And at the end we have par save, which means parameter save, and this means scalar. This stores parameters into the par.prm file like this. So example, and if you have any doubts about this function, just look into the ANSYS help section. This is all from there. See, this is not a MATLAB functions. And now coming to how to launch the ANSYS. So just concentrate on second part, which this is mainly the location of ANSYS installed, and I is for input, and we input the macro file .mac, and this is the output pre.txt. As you can see, the output will mostly consist of like these things, statistics, and this has been completed, and other data like node number, and even errors will be there like error warning, and the first part of this is a set function which sets the stack size of the ANSYS, and this should be minimum of 2k. I would suggest minimum of like 2000k, and the default will be 512k, which is not enough to run ANSYS, and make sure you put AND here. So use this set function to set the stack size to 4096 or minimum 2000k. And to run this launch.bat file, that is to run the ANSYS, you just type DOS launch.bat, and this will run the input file, which is your bash shaft.mac. Your results will be stored in a response file, and just read that response and put it into a Excel sheet. It should be better. That's all for this video, and thanks for watching.